بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The ayah I'm going to talk about today, maybe great many of us know the ayah, but I think you can hardly find one out of a thousand who knows the meanings of this ayah. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى. There are three ordinances and three prohibitions. وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي. يعظكم لعلكم تذكروا. There are three do's and three don'ts. What is العدل? العدل means it is not justice. Justice is one of the meanings. العدل means how you maintain values, measurements, appreciations in the lawful and legal way. Anything which is out of place, incongruous, inconvenient, is out of the adl area. For example, Allah in the Quran says for a husband and wife how they should follow up their rights and duties. Allah says وَلَهُنَّ مِثْلُ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. A wife has as many rights as many she has of commitments and duties. Which means for both man and wife or husband and wife. So that is the first ordinance. Then what is al-ihsan? Al-ihsan when you do more than what is due. For example, if somebody gives you, say, a value of 10, the adl is to give 10. But the ihsan, if you give 11 or 12, you see? Anything you do of more, of better, is of ihsan. You see, even in our studies of Sharia, the Sharia teaches us that even when you slaughter an animal, you can slaughter the animal in a good way, but the sharper the knife is, the better it is. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in a hadith says, when you slaughter أحسن الذبحة. What is أحسن الذبحة? For example, sometimes you bring two lambs and you slaughter a lamb in front of the other lamb. This is ugly. But it is not haram. You are doing okay. But if you keep the other lamb away that won't suffer watching the other lamb being slaughtered, then that is of ihsan al-dhabih. You are doing better than what is required. إِذَا حُيِّيتُم بِتَحِيَّةٍ. Somebody says, Assalamu alaykum. The Quran teaches us how we can make ihsan in saluting the other. فَحَيُّوا بِأَحْسَنَ مِنْهَا أَوْ رُدُّوهَا. Either you say, Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, that is ahsan. Or you say, Wa alaykum assalam, that is the response. So, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان. الإحسان then means to do more than what is required in practicing justice, or what we call عدل, which is more than justice. Thirdly, إيتاء ذي القربى. It means you go to your relative. If he is in need of help, you should not let him ask you for help. Ita is zakah. Why it is ita? Because you need not let the poor or the needy come to you and ask for the zakah. No. You detect, you look for, you investigate, and then when you tell that there is a certain person in need of zakah, you go and knock at the door or call on a telephone, etc. إيتاء ذي القربى. Those are the three ordinances. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله.